I want to share a few words that the Lord has put on my heart, and I wrote them down and I want to read them for you. They say Jesus didn't preach the law because the Jews already kept the law. But if you say, well, why was Jesus sent for the lost sheep of Israel then? Well, they say the Jews didn't keep the law correctly. Why didn't Jesus teach them how to keep the law of Moses, if it was that important? I mean, as all the prophets sent by God to the Jews to mend their ways, which were persecuted and killed. Jesus himself sent his disciples to preach the gospel into the whole world. Why didn't he mention keeping the Sabbath on Saturdays? Why didn't his disciples include that in their writings? What's with all the other teachings of Jesus? Didn't the Jews know they have to love one another? How come Abraham knew that before the book of the law? And Job and Noah, how did they know? For 400 years they did not receive a word from God. They had the book of the law, but it didn't profit them. Today, some 2,400 years later, some still claim they keep the law of Moses. They're hypocrites. They try to keep 30-40% of the Old Testament law and prophets at best. For the rest, they find excuses. They have their scriptures, which now they call the Word of God, but the true Word of God is scarcer than gold. Apostle Paul, the apostle of the Gentiles, never preached the law of Moses to the Gentiles. He never preached the Sabbath to the Thessalonians, which were the Greeks. He never preached the Sabbath to the Ephesians, which were the Turks. He never preached the Sabbath in Rome or anywhere he was. He preached the new covenant in Christ Jesus. He preached the gospel because this is what the Lord sent us to preach. What are you preaching? Jesus didn't destroy the law and the prophets, but he is indeed the fulfillment of the law and prophets. The rest of the chapter in Matthew chapter 5, Jesus repeatedly says, ye have heard that it was said by them of old time, but I say unto you. He speaks these words at verse 21, at verse 27, at verse 31, and again at verse 33, at verse 38, and at verse 43. Jesus has many more things to say to us, but without the Holy Spirit, those who claim to keep the law and prophets cannot bear them. Neither can those who follow doctrines and religions of men. This is why we need the Holy Spirit. This is why we need to follow His guidance. But most Christians think they don't need the Holy Spirit and they don't want Him. Jesus will tell them, you have been used to do this and that according to your doctrine, but I tell you, this is what they don't want, and they cannot humble themselves and serve the living God. Jesus gave us the right to become children of God. He gave us the right to be born again of the Spirit of God, and we have the opportunity to follow the guidance of the Spirit of God, not our own interpretations of the Scriptures. And the fruit of the Spirit must abound in us. Not keeping the Sabbath on Saturdays, not eating certain foods, not keeping Jewish festive days. No, we belong to the kingdom of God and we bear the fruit of the Spirit of God. The true children of God are those who follow the guidance of the Spirit of God, and we know them by their fruit, not by dead religious practices. My Jesus bless you.